Hi friends, welcome to Tackle Knowledge Channel. So let's continue with the White and White Biochemistry Textual book. Okay, so today we are going to see from here. Prokaryotes have relatively simple anatomies. Prokaryotes, which were first observed in 1683 by the inventor of the microscope, Antony van Leeuwenhoek, have sizes that are mostly in the range 1 to 10 micrometers. So first, prokaryotes were observed in 1683, okay, by inventor of the microscope. So the microscope was invented by scientist Antony van Leeuwenhoek, okay. So the prokaryotes sizes is mostly ranging from 1 to 10 micrometers, okay. They have one of three basic shapes, figure 1.1. So if we see the figure 1.1, scales drawings of some prokaryotic cells. So they have three basic shapes, okay. So first one is the spirulum, a spirochete, anabina, cyanobacterium, Escherichia coli, large bacillus, staphylococcus, rickettsia, three species of microplasma. So all these are having different shapes, okay. Spheroidal cocci, rod-like bacilli, and helical coiled spirilla, but all have the same general designs, figure 1.2. So if we see the figure 1.2, all these type of shapes are available in the figure 1.2, which is a schematic diagram of a prokaryotic cell, okay. They are bounded, as are all cells, by an approximate 70 angstrom thick cell membrane, plasma membrane, which consists of lipid bilayer containing embedded proteins that controls the passage of molecules in and out of the cell and catalyze a variety of reactions. So here the cell membrane is approximately 70 angstrom thick, okay. So it is bounded by the cell, okay. So the cell membrane is covering the whole cell and it is acts like a boundary, okay, which consists of a lipid bilayer containing embedded proteins. So the lipid bilayer, which is having proteins on embedded in that lipid bilayer, okay, which are controlling the passage of molecules in and out of the cell, okay, and catalyze a variety of reactions. So the passage of molecules in and out of the cell is also catalyzing variety of reactions, okay. The cells of most prokaryotic species are surrounded by a rigid 30 to 250 angstrom thick polysaccharide cell wall that mainly functions to protect the cell from mechanical injury and to prevent it from bursting in media more osmotically dilute than its content. So the cell, most of the prokaryotic species are surrounded by a rigid cell wall, okay. So the polysaccharide cell wall is 30 to 250 angstrom thick, okay. Mainly the cell wall is functioning to protect the cell from mechanical injuries and preventing it from bursting in media, okay, more osmotically diluted than its content, okay. So the cell is supporting from protecting from the mechanical injury and preventing it from bursting in media or osmotically diluted than its content, okay. Some bacteria further encase themselves in a gelatinous polysaccharide capsule that protects them from the defense of higher organisms. So the bacteria encases gelatinous polysaccharide known as capsule, okay. So the capsule is protecting them from defensing of higher organisms, okay. So they are defensing the higher organisms which are present outside the cell, okay. Although prokaryotes lack the membranous subcellular organelles characteristics of eukaryotes, section 1.2, their plasma membranes may be infolded to form multilayered structures known as mesosomes. So although prokaryotes lack membranes, okay, membranous subcellular organelles. So the prokaryotes which are containing subcellular organelles, they lack the membranous, okay, they lack the membranes. So the characteristics of eukaryotes, their plasma may be infolded to form multilayered structures known as mesosomes. So the multilayered structures are infolded in the form of a mesosomes. The mesosomes are thought to serve as the site of DNA replication and other specialized enzymatic reactions. So the mesosomes are there to serve as a site of DNA replication, and it is specialized for enzymatic reactions. Okay, the prokaryotic cytoplasm cell contains is by no means a homogeneous soup. Its single chromosome DNA molecule serve several copies of which may be present in rapidly growing cells. So the prokaryotic cytoplasm, which is having a cell content, by no means of homogeneous soup. Okay, so the cell contents are present inside the cytoplasm. The cytoplasm is like a gelatinous, which we will be calling it as a homogeneous soup. Okay, its single chromosome DNA molecule, several copies may be present in wrapping growing cell. So the several copies of the DNA are in the wrapped form, wrapping form. Okay, they wrap it. Several copies are wrapped in a chromosome. Okay, it's condensed to form a body known as nucleoid. So inside the chromosome, this DNA molecule is wrapped in several copies, and it is condensed to form a body known as nucleoid. So in this is the nucleoid. So it is having a chromosomes. Okay, the chromosomes are chromosomes containing DNA. So these chromosomes are in the condensed form. Okay, the cytoplasm also contains numerous species of RNA, ribonucleic acid, a variety of soluble enzymes, proteins that catalyze species reactions, and many thousands of 250 Armstrong diameter particles known as ribosomes, which are the sites of protein synthesis. So if we see the cytoplasm, which is containing numerous species of RNA, okay, the cytoplasm containing a numerous species of RNA, it is having a variable soluble enzymes, okay, proteins that catalyze specific reactions, and many thousands have 250 Armstrong diameter particles known as ribosomes. Okay, so these ribosomes are the sites of protein synthesis. Okay, next, many bacterial cells bear one or more whip-like appendages known as flagella. So the bacterial cells bear one or more whip-like appendages known as flagella. So the bacteria containing this flagellas. Okay, so these are the flagellas. Bacteria is having this flagellas outside the cell. Okay, they are floating, which are used for locomotion. So these are helping for the locomotion for the bacteria. Okay, locomotion for the bacteria. Certain bacteria also have filamentous projection named pili, some types of which functions as conducts for DNA during sexual conjugation, a process in which DNA is transferred from one cell to another. So if you see the certain bacteria having filamentous projections like pili, so this is the pili. So it is having a pili present on the bacteria. Okay, so these are pili. So these pili are some type of functions conducting a DNA during sexual conjugation. So they are helping in the sexual conjugation. During sexual conjugation, this pili is helping for the processing in a which DNA is transferred from one cell to another. So this is making another cell to contact with each other. Okay, prokaryotes usually reproduce by binary fission. So prokaryotes usually reproduce by binary fission itself, or aid in the attachment of the bacteria to host organism cells. So the bacterium is attached to the host organism cells. The DNA is transferred from one cell to another. Okay, the bacterium Escherichia coli, abbreviated E. coli, and named after it, discoverer Theodore Escherich is the biologically most well characterized organism as a result of its intensive biochemical and genetic study over the past 70 years. So the scientist Theodore Escherich, he discovered the Escherichia coli, and he abbreviated this Escherichia coli as a E. coli, okay? And biologically most well characterized organisms are resulted for intensive biochemical and genetic study over past 70 years, okay? Indeed, much of the subject matter of this text deals with biochemistry of the E. coli. So the subject matter of the text is text of biochemistry of E. coli is dealing in this subject matter, okay? Cells of this normal inhabitant of the higher mammalian colon are typically 2 micrometers long rods that are 1 micrometer in diameter and weigh approximately 2 × 10^12 grams. So if you see the normal cell, it is inhabitant of higher mammalian colon, okay? The E. coli is present inside the mammalian colon, okay? These E. coli are typically 2 micrometers long, okay? Rods that are 1 micrometer in diameter. So long rods are among 2 micrometers and 1 micrometer in diameter, okay? In diameter and weighing is approximately 2 × 10^-12 grams. So the weight of the bacterium is approximately 2 × 10^12 grams. Its DNA, which has a molecular mass of 2.5 × 10^9 Daltons. So the DNA which is having, this bacteria is having DNA, the molecular mass of that DNA is 2.5 × 10^9 Daltons, okay? Encodes approximate 4300 proteins. So those are encoding, the DNA is encoding approximate 4300 proteins, okay? Of which only approximate 60% to 70% have been identified. So approximately 60% to 70% of proteins have been identified. Although typically only approximate 2600 different proteins are present in the cell at any given time. So the approximately 2600 different proteins are present in a cell at a given time. Okay. Altogether, an E. coli cell contains 3,000 to 6,000 different types of molecules, including proteins, nucleic acids, polysaccharides, lipids, and various small molecules and ions. Table 1.1. So the E. coli containing 3,000 to 6,000 different types of molecules, including proteins, nucleic acids, okay, polysaccharides, lipids, and various small molecules and ions. Okay, we will be seeing table 1.1. Molecular composition of E. coli. Component percentage of weight. So there is the water molecule having percentage 70%. Protein is having 15%. Nucleic acids, DNA is having 1%. RNA is having 6%. Polysaccharides and precursors having 3%, lipid and precursors having 2%, other small organic molecules having 1%, inorganic ions having 1%. So this is the tabular column of the molecular composition of E. coli. Okay. Okay, friends, thank you. Thanks for watching. If you like my video, please kindly like, share, and subscribe it with your friends also. Thank you. Thank you so much. Bye bye.